Those teachings, they paralyze your spiritual life. They paralyze your righteousness. They paralyze you that you cannot go, you cannot move, keep on moving to the kingdom of God. You remain standing there, you have become paralyzed. You are not moving, you are not growing, you cannot speak, you cannot walk, you cannot stand. That's why you see, there are people who are right there in those churches, but when we try to call them, they are paralyzed, they cannot speak, they cannot walk, they cannot move. You try to shout at them, to tell them, come out, they cannot, they are paralyzed.
Sure.
You try to tell them, free from them, run away, they cannot, they have been paralyzed by the false teachings.
Sure.
Praise the name of the Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
They are like dead.
Mm.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
They cannot even hear, because their organs or their ear have been made like deaf. Their eyes have been made like a blind. They cannot see. They bring comfort to sin.
Uh-huh.
Amen? They bring comfort to sin. How do they bring comfort to sin? Is that you feel okay with the sin.
Yeah.
Amen?
Amen?
Praise the name of the Lord Jesus.
Amen.
Yeah. There are people who are in those churches, but they feel comfortable and they are in fornication. They feel comfortable and they are in nakedness.
Sure.
They feel comfortable and they are in adultery.
Yes.
They feel comfortable and they are in masturbation.
Yes.
They say masturbation is not sin and they continue.
Yes.
So what are they trying to do? Makeup is not sin. Wearing immoral dressing is not sin. False teaching, they paralyze you. They make you comfortable in a sin that you don't mind. And when you are comfortable, you become like a reprobate. That you are wallowing in sin, but you don't care. That they cannot feel anything. They are comfortable until they land in hell. They are killing the seriousness of the church. They are killing the seriousness of the church. They are killing a serious Christian. They take away that seriousness.
Sure.
Your seriousness begins growing cold.
Yes.
If you are on fire of God, your fire begin dropping.
Yes.
If you had the hope of Christ Jesus, your hope, you start losing that hope.
Okay.
If you are serious on walking with your God, you do not walk in holiness.
Yes.
You see, when you go there, your seriousness will be taken.
Sure.
They will kill your zeal. They will kill your holiness.
Yes.
They will kill your power, your faith.
Yes.
They will kill what you believe.
Yes.
That's why we are told to check on ourselves. Who are those that we fellowship with?
Yes.
Who are those that we walk with?
Amen.
They are killing your seriousness. If they are not supporting you to be serious, they are killing your seriousness. They are killing your zeal.
Yes.
They are killing your faith. They are killing your holiness.
Yes.
Or are treading someone that is treading right now.
Yes.
And those people, they are the most famous. They are the most people who you see they are accommodating even the homosexual in the church.
Yes.
Because they don't believe the existence of the sin.
Mm.
They say sin do not exist. Since we are in the grace, there is no sin. That's why people are coming, people are flocking to their church because they believe there is no sin.
Yes.
And when you preach that kind of a gospel, which you tell people there is no sin, that all you need to do is to believe Jesus and be saved by the grace.
Yes.
I tell you, all people will follow you. Even the devil will follow you. The witches will follow you. Because they say they believe there is no sin. Just accept Jesus.
Yes.
Just believe Jesus.
Yes.
There is no sin. So you can be a Christian. You can be a drunkard. God do not care. There is no sin.
Yes.
You can be a homosexual. What they have in the churches. A recipient. But there is no sin.
Yes.
You can be adultery, you can be doing what you are doing, you can walk naked. There is no sin actually.
Yes.
We are in the grace. That is a venomous teaching, a venomous teaching. A teaching of Antichrist.
Yes.
They don't believe hell, they don't believe sin. And that is the teaching that the preachers are preaching in the churches. There is no hell, there is no sin. Why did Jesus Christ came? Why did the apostles preach? What was the message they were preaching? Why did they all shout, repent,
yes.
repent? What is that they were speaking? They were speaking about sin.
Yes.
Jesus spoke about sin. Prophets spoke about sin.
Yes.
But for them, they are saying there is no sin. Who are they? Are they imitating the devil?
Yes.